So, in this short little video, we're going to be making a tactical combat spatula. Normally, as any of you have sent me messages, know, I am allergic to doing these small jobs. But this thing was just silly enough that it was on my radar for a while. And, you know, this guy has been sending me messages for a while now, so... Eventually, it was just silly enough to cross the threshold. You know, it wasn't like a, you know, people asked me to make regular knives and stuff, and I wouldn't even be a good choice for doing that work. Never mind the fact that I find it boring. What has he specified? 9.5 inch length. Boop, boop. I just want to work out the angle. He hasn't got the angle that the spatula is at down here. So I just wanted to draw a thing and make sure it doesn't look silly before I begin. And so then he's made it 16 inches total. So that would be here. And he's wanted a 5 inch grip. So that will be here. Huh. This looks much steeper. See the way he's drawn his little freehand drawing. No, I guess that's right. It's only this little bit here. This little 1.5 inch. And then, if we're roughly copying the drawing, then it's 1.75 to do this kind of a slope. I'll draw a little bit better than this, but I just wanted to make sure it didn't look silly before I started. The way he's drawn it, this is a thing that with a lot of you guys who send me pictures of stuff that you've drawn. The way he's drawn it, it actually looks quite stockier. It looks stockier than his sketch that he sent me. And I'm going to go with his measurements because presumably the measurements were based on something relating to reality. But I often have that choice to make when people send me pictures of things. Do you want me to go by the actual dimensions you've sent me, or by your picture? I'm going to go with the dimensions on this one, because they don't look too bad, but they do look different, you know? This is a different set of proportions to this. Too, with such a little delicate edge, I want to tighten up the disc.
Don't do this.
Shaves more precisely when it's trimmed down. Getting late now. I don't know. That'll be a bastard of a thing to try and shoot the camera to focus on, but that's the idea. It's only stainless steel, so it's highly debatable how good of a blade that is. I should be able to cut food at least. So these are two slabs for the handle that I got to shape, but I want to make sure they match up nice. And you could dick around with clamps and stuff. Because I'm a welder, I like to dick around with the welder. Just a little tack on the bottom. I don't actually have any stainless TIG rods. I'm using a piece of discarded stainless MIG rod. Or it's not even rod, it's the spool, the stainless spool. Sides of these guys and the ends of these guys so that they match up nicely. I might sink the other side in a little deeper. These guys don't need to be directly on the surface. Let these guys poke out a little bit more. They're halfway through the material as it is. Maybe up that to 3/4 of the way through. Sink these guys by a mil and a half. So this will be for holding the leather. The drawing calls for sword-esque leather on the handle. Now, I'm not sure how good leather around a handle is in a kitchen-type environment, but I'm going to do my best, and if he needs to take it off, well, it's a stainless steel handle underneath. I'm going to round this guy off too, but I wanted to drill all these holes and such first. Don't like stainless steel. It's odd. It cuts easy, it grinds easy, but drilling it is weird. Like, it does not like to be drilled. Like, it's, you can see the edges of the hole. It's almost like the drill bit is pushing the stuff out of the way instead of doing a nice clean cut. It's very hard to drill, but at the same time, its surface polishes easier, which would suggest it's softer. So, I don't know. This will be on the back of the handle. And hopefully these are roundy enough that they don't interfere with the actual holding of it and such. Check that this fits in. A big lump of something. You. This may look like a random pile of crap, and that's because largely it is. But I'm going to use it to build a nice bend in the spatula. So now, will this work? End in disaster. No, we're close. I think that's worth investigating. Less, more. But that means I just have to remember to bend the other bit more. Okie doke. Now this bit, I wonder, can I get away with doing the next bit just through raw muscular effort? There we go. Hang on, where's the camera gone? Tactical combat spatula. That seems about right compared to ones I've looked at. To polishing it up a bit, there's kind of a line It's not a full line. If it was a full line, it'd be more acceptable, I think. There's where the edge of the blade I was using to do the bending was touching off the steel. Stainless steel being a little bit softer than the... probably high carbon. That was the edge of one of those guillotine blades I had lying around. An offcut from one from doing something. But I think I'd do... It's annoying. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I'd do more damage trying to polish them out. Because they're at the crook of the corner. If they were like out here, it'd be easier. But because they're at the crook of the corner, I was thinking I'd get the drill and the rotary out. But I'm just worried that anything I can think of will cause more damage than just leaving it alone. The goal here is to create something that's relatively easy to take on and off. Because I do think we're going to wind up with an issue that even for cleaning and stuff, you might want to take this off occasionally. If you're not content to just wash off the blade itself, and then if this gets too greasy or whatever, you might want to just replace the leather completely. So I don't want to make it too complex. Clean this up, but that's the idea. So, as is often the way when I make one of these smaller items, I made two of them. And as per usual, the second one will be going up for auction, charity auction. So if you would like to own a tactical combat spatula and you would like to make the world a little bit less awful, why don't you check out the video description, send me a message. The opening bid and how much time is left in the auction will be in the video description too.